Hi everybody, Dan Jablons here with Retail Smart Guys, and I wanted to do this video quickly because I've been learning about a program that I want to share with you that's pretty exciting. It's exciting enough that I actually put a jacket on. That should tell you something, right? Now, you guys who know me know that Retail Smart Guys is in the business of helping independent retailers generate more profit, be more successful, generate more sales, but also certainly more cash flow. And man, this program I'm about to share with you is a way the federal government is also contributing to your cash flow, so check this out. The program is called the ERTC, Employee Retention Tax Credit. And the way it works is you have to compare your revenues from 2019 to 2020 and also 2021, okay? If you were down 50% in 2020 or down 20% in 2021, you are suddenly eligible for this incredible tax credit. How much of a tax credit is? Wait till you hear this. For any employees that you had in 2020, you can earn as much as a $5,000 tax credit per employee. For 2021, you can earn as much as a $7,000 tax credit per quarter per employee, which means that if you retained employees for 2020 and 2021, okay, it could be as much as $33,000 in tax credits per employee. That's some serious money, right? Okay, so here's the thing. First off, qualifications can be a little bit confusing. Here's just one of the confusing ones, right? As an owner of the business, you and your spouse qualify. But blood relatives like your children or your parents or your grandparents or your nieces and nephews, they don't qualify. That's crazy, I know, but it's one of the rules. I don't know why. I only run my business, not the federal government. But anyway, so that's one of the rules you have to know about, and you have to understand how to do that. The second one you have to know about is you can't double dip. What do I mean by that? If you got PPP money and you're applying for forgiveness in that, okay? If you, as you probably know, when you apply for forgiveness on the PPP, a good chunk of it has to go to payroll, but there's also portions of it that you can use for other things like rent, like vendor invoices, like safety equipment for your employees during COVID, right? So if you're smart about how you do your PPP forgiveness, you leave yourself dollars available to use towards the ERTC tax credit. So you have to think strategically about how you do your PPP forgiveness and how you apply for the ERTC. All right, so look, it's complicated, and it's not something that just you want to do on your own. So first things first, your payroll company probably isn't doing this, but your CPA might be doing this. If your CPA is doing it, great. Ask your CPA if they're doing it. If they are doing it, if they have a great understanding for it, go with your CPA. Don't bother with us. But if your CPA isn't doing it, or if you get the thing like maybe they're not so up on it, then you want to reach out to us because we've got a pretty great crew of people that know how to ask the right questions, how to figure out the tax credit properly, how to make you understand the best ways to file for PPP forgiveness so that you maximize that forgiveness plus the ERTC. Okay? I'm super excited about this. I'm doing it myself within Retail Smart Guys. You should be doing it within your own business as well. Ask your CPA about it. If you're not sure about it, ask us. If you want us to be on a phone call with your CPA to talk about it, we'll do that too. Okay? So check out this ERTC thing. If you're not sure about it at all, you know, my contact information is right here. Write to me or call me on my cell. I'm more than happy to help you. That's what we do at Retail Smart Guys. We're here to help you generate as much cash flow as we possibly can. So I hope this was helpful. I hope it piqued your interest, and I hope you act on it quickly. Dan Jablons here for Retail Smart Guys. Thank you again, and we'll talk soon.